talk about velocity. Okay, so velocity here is represented by the symbol V, but this time, different from speed, we have a right arrow vector on top. That means this velocity here, it's a vector quantity. When we say vector quantity, we know that there must be magnitude and direction. Okay, so this time, velocity signifies how fast an object changes position. Okay, if you remember, it's slightly different from speed that we mentioned in the previous video. In speed, I write, it signifies how fast an object moves. But here, I say it signifies how fast an object changes position. Why? Because changes position, right, doesn't really depend on path. When we talk about velocity, right, it doesn't really depend on path. So it's more on like, at what time I am at where, and another time where am I. Okay, it's more on this kind of change position rather than I move here, there, and I end up here. Okay, the path is irrelevant when we talk about velocity, just like displacement. Okay, so I change the statement here to be how fast an object changes position. And of course, since vector, velocity here is a vector, we know that it also represents the direction of change of position. Okay, so later we will see what is direction of change of position. Okay, so now let's say from time 0 to time 3, I want to determine the average velocity. Okay, I remove everything that is not relevant to time 3 and time 0, because as I mentioned just now, velocity don't really care about the path you go in order to get from the initial position to the final position. It only cares at the initial moment, at the earlier time, where is your position? At the later time, where is your position? That's what average velocity cares about. Okay, so average velocity is a vector. So from time 0 to time 3, you can determine this average velocity here by taking the displacement from time 0 to time 3 divided by the time duration between time 0 and time 3. Again, this displacement here is a vector. And if you remember from a previous the video on displacement, the displacement will be pointing from the initial position towards the final position. That's the displacement vector, and you represent it with the vector S. Okay, so now this is a equation that involves vector. When we want to do calculation involving vectors, we know that the direction cannot be neglected. But how do we divide direction? Well, we don't really put in the vector straight away like this. What we do is we split the vector into its components, x and y components. But since in this case, there's only motion in the x direction, there's no motion in the y direction, so everything will be resolved to the x component. Okay, so if you break it to the x component, you get the average velocity x component equals to the displacement x component divided by the time duration. Everything is in the x component. Okay, for the x component of displacement, it's equivalent to the change of position in the x dimension. So, which is also equivalent to the final position in the x component of the final position minus x component of the initial position. Then you divide by the duration between time 0 and time 3. Until here, I believe it's still okay. So, substitution. x3 is over here. We know x3 is negative 7. So this is the x component of the position, the final position, minus the initially you are at origin, so minus 0, divided by the duration, which is 5 seconds. So substitute 5 seconds, and once you calculate everything, get negative 1.4 meter per second. So since you see there's a negative sign here, you know that the velocity vector will be pointing towards the left hand side, which is the negative x direction. Okay? But now you have to re-express your answer back in terms of vector form, right? So you have to combine the x component and the y component back using Pythagoras theorem, which I am not showing here. But since y component, there's nothing. So if you do go through the Pythagoras theorem, which you don't actually need to write it down, okay? You get 1.4 meter per second. You change the negative sign to positive sign through the Pythagoras theorem. And you have to write down the direction. Because it's negative, it means by the direction is towards the negative x direction. Okay, so this is the average velocity from time 0 to time 3. But as you can see here, this 1.4 meter per second towards the negative x direction is irrelevant at all to the path that has been taken by this person to get from x0 to x3. If you remember the path, there's a U-turn that we made here, but this negative 1.4 meter per second here takes no account or doesn't care at all about the path that is being traveled because it is calculated using displacement. And when we mentioned in the video on displacement doesn't care about the path as well. Okay, so what does this negative 1.4 meter per second means? Well, it actually represents the most direct way or the easiest way you can to get from the initial position to the final position at the time interval being specified. Okay, what does it mean? If I want to get from the initial position to the final position at 5 seconds, using 5 seconds, the easiest way to do it is to travel at a speed of 1.4 meter per second towards the negative x direction. If I travel at this speed towards this direction for 5 seconds, I will be traveling from the initial position to the final position using the most direct way. Okay, that's the idea of average velocity in my opinion. Okay, so let's move on to another example. Let's say now I want t0 to t2, which is the motion from here to here, make a U-turn, come back to here. But again, the path is irrelevant. We only need to know at t0 where is it, at t2 where is it. So let's remove everything. This is t0, this is also t2. Okay, so basically it comes back to its initial position. So final position is at the same place as the initial position. So if we determine the average velocity, again the x component will be the x component of displacement divided by the time duration. If we go through the process, this time it's x2 minus x0. But now the time duration is from 0 to 2. And as if you see here, I mentioned from 0 to 2, the time 0 to time 2 here is 3 seconds. The 2 here doesn't mean second, not 2 seconds. Time 2 here means the second moment. This is the 0th moment. The moment it makes a U-turn is the first moment. The second moment is the moment that it passed through the origin. This label here labels moment. It doesn't mean it's second, okay? So the duration from t0 to t2 is 3 seconds. So if you substitute everything, 0 minus 0 divided by 3, you get 0 meter per second. Then now, if you put it back into vector form, there will be 0 meter per second as well. Again, well, does 0 meter per second tells you anything about path? No. Okay, so average velocity doesn't care at all how you get from the initial position to the final position in the exact scenario. It doesn't care at all. What does it care? It cares initial moment, where am I? Final moment, where am I? Okay, that's average velocity. And again, what does average velocity means? It means it's the simplest way to get from the initial position to the final position using the time duration specified. Okay, so 0 meter per second is of course the easiest way to get from the initial position to the final position using 3 seconds. Well, that's the easiest way, right? Just stay there. You don't need to move at all. Then you get from the initial position to the final position. The easiest way. Okay? Okay, so that's all for this average velocity.